Hey everyone, I'm Thomas, Lead Product Manager for SAP HANA Cloud. For the last time in 2024, I'm thrilled to give you an exclusive preview of the upcoming innovations in our Q4 delivery of SAP HANA Cloud. Let's dive in and see the exciting new features you will be able to use with the upcoming release. Long time awaited after the release of the Vector Engine in SAP HANA Cloud earlier this year, I'm super proud to announce that we're adding an embedding function natively to SAP HANA Cloud. This means with a Q4 release, you will be able to create vector embeddings from stored text data directly within your SAP HANA Cloud environment. Additionally, the new text chunking functionality will help cutting down larger text elements into smaller pieces to simplify text analysis and vector generation. Alongside this, we're also supercharging our predictive analysis library within SAP HANA Cloud with additional text analysis capabilities. Functionalities such as word segmentation, fact or entity extraction will enable you to analyze textual data using natural language processing techniques and extract information so you can add sentiment analysis to your applications. In today's fast-driven business environments, companies require a significant degree of flexibility to be able to adapt to changing conditions. This flexibility includes the need for dynamic scaling options of their database. And to meet this need with a Q4 release, we're introducing elastic horizontal scaling capabilities. Our so-called elastic compute nodes will help you to effortlessly handle peak workloads as they provide capacity to your system, which you can add temporarily. This will avoid the resizing of your primary system node and thus is definitely a key release highlight for SAP HANA Cloud in Q4. Next up, I'm happy to share that we're adding lightweight and native multi-tenancy at schema level to SAP HANA Cloud. In simple terms, this allows you to manage data in separate database tenants within the same database instance. Starting this quarter, you will be able to create and delete database tenants with ease and make use of tenant-level features like recovery, customer-specific data encryption, and workload management. The management of such native tenants will be available via REST API. And via such multi-tenant architectures, you will be able to improve cost effectiveness while maintaining secure data separation at the same time. Equally important as the flexible usage of your available resources is deployment flexibility in the cloud. Therefore, we have extended SAP HANA Cloud's data center landscape even further. This quarter, we're making SAP HANA Cloud available in Microsoft Azure in Sao Paulo, Brazil, and on Google Cloud Platform in Sydney, Australia. Finally, I want to mention an enhancement for our SQL on Files data processing capabilities. Earlier this year, we have announced the native integration of SQL-based data processing of files stored on the data lake within our SAP HANA database. Now, I'm happy to share that we will be able to integrate your external data lakes next to it, streamlining data integration and avoiding data duplication. As always, this was just a handpicked list of highlights of our upcoming release of SAP HANA Cloud. To learn more about these advancements, join our What's New in SAP HANA Cloud webcast or visit our website. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to not miss any updates. Until next time, take care and see you soon.